Hi, Monica here, and in this video we are gonna work on the calculated field for this survey questions that we are working on. So to do that, go to your JetForm and edit it. On the left side, search for calculated field. For this one, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna drag this after the last question that I have per page, because on the past video we have divided these questions into three like pages using the form page break. So I'm gonna put that in here on the last question, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna name this category 1 average, and then I'm gonna start grabbing the value. So to use the calculated field, we need to grab those values from the first or whatever fields that we have set. So in my case, since this is category 1 average, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna first call the category 1 Q1. So we're just gonna focus on category 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so let's grab the category 1 hyphen Q1. So as you can see, that's the format that we have. So there's a percentage and then the form field name. And then I'm just gonna add that. So Q1 plus Q2 and then Q3. And of course, to take the average, I'm gonna divide this into 3. And if I update this, let's see how that looks. So if I say like always, so as you can see, it inputted the 5 because always value is 5. So we have never as 1, rarely as 2, sometimes is 3, often as 4. So that's how it is calculating that. So since I'm only selecting the first question for now, only that is the captured value. So I say like always, and then let's say sometimes, and then rarely, and then it got the, there's an average going on already. Now I'm just gonna go back and I'm just gonna make sure I separate this properly. So I put close parenthesis, and then so we add this first, then we divide it into 3. Next is I'm gonna click this item, and then on the right side I'm gonna open the block editor, and then I'm gonna select this one as a number. I only need 1 decimal place, and then I need this to be hidden later, but for now I'm just gonna leave it that way. So now if we refresh this page, and let's try that again. So we have never, so it already divided. As you can see, this is 1, and then it's divided into 3, right? Because we're trying to take the average. Earlier, it did not calculate it that way. Without this parenthesis, what's gonna happen is it's only gonna do the division on the last item that we have, which is category 1 question 3. So we really need to put that inside a parenthesis, and then never, and then rarely. So this is my average, let's just say. So I'm gonna try to increase this a bit. So I have 4.3 if I select this. So that's how you use the calculated field. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna duplicate this and just drag that on the other categorized question. So this time, I'm just gonna change this to cat 2, and then I'm gonna remove the copy, and then just change the numbers in here. So cat 2 question 1, cat 2 question 2, cat 2 question 3. And the same, repeated the steps for the last category. Category 3, and then category So if I refresh and we proceed to the next page, so let's just say always, always. And then here, it's also separate. So as you can see, it started with zero because it's only gonna calculate this page average because of this calculation that we set in here. Next is, I also want to like get the average of overall. So to do that, I'm gonna duplicate this and I'm gonna say overall average. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna call those average that we have per category. So we have category one average. I'm gonna add that. And then category two, category three. And then of course, don't forget to put this inside parentheses and then divide it into three. And then on the right side, we still, that's fine. I'm gonna leave it that way. So now if I like example, say always, often, sometimes, and then I proceed with other questions here. So as you can see, there's a second field and that is like calculating the overall average of your questions here. Now you can also add a label. So example here, overall average. And then this one is category three average. Let's also put some on the first two, category one, category two. So we now have that field as a recognizer of this first and the next one, category two. So that's how you use the calculated field of the JetForm survey that we are currently setting up right now. So we have finished setting up the survey questions, assigned value, and then the calculated average. So in the next video, we are gonna proceed to the other list that we have in here. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye-bye.